Hello from Craig. I'm going to explain the RPM settings in the TFS control panel. We happen to be running R-Factor, and here you have the intelliVIBE real-time output chart, and you can see this waveform here. That's because we're in a car where the engine is idling here, and this is what the engine idle intelliVIBE waveform looks like. This waveform is created because you've got a 5.5% setting here and a 12.5% setting there. This is 5.5% low idle, high idle at 12.5 by the green line. You'll notice this waveform is blue. If you look down at the in-game engine specs, here you have your engine red line at 8,000 RPM here. You've got when your car is on and the engine is idling but there's no throttle, we're at 1600 RPM. That's just the in-game engine specification. This happens to be a stock car, like a NASCAR. And you'll see this gauge here is the real-time RPM in the game, or in the sim. So you've got 1600 RPM here, and you'll notice we're at the bottom of the blue area. Now, if I give a little bit of throttle, okay, you'll notice that in this chart, looking at this gauge first, this here is the in-game RPM. I'm throttling up in neutral, okay? And you'll see here's the blue, and the peaks of what we just did is the vibration you feel from the engine RPM. So if I throttle up a little bit to climb to this number, okay, you'll notice that this waveform flattens out. So the blue area, the closer we get to the green area, the flatter this vibration gets. As the engine RPM drops, it gets more rumbly when you're at your lowest idle. So as we speed up the engine RPM, it flattens. Now you're in your normal RPM range. So this 8,000 is your engine red line in the sim. This 3,000 is a preference where you're kind of leaving the idle area. Generally, this is about twice this value. So here we're at engine idle again. And I'm going to throttle up. You'll notice the waveform climb. And there's red line. And then we'll drop the throttle. So this setting right here is that low idle. This can be raised. To flatten this completely, you would just set these two numbers to be the same. So let's say that we go to 10.2 and 10.2. You'll notice this line is flat. So if we accelerate now, we get the engine idle RPM is no longer a waveform. It's a flat line. It's a flat strength of vibration here. If we drop this, you'll see the waveform come back, and then you'll see the rumbly of the engine idle here. So the settings typically are 5.5 and 12.5 because they generally look good, or feel good rather. And iVIBE at redline 20%, that's the maximum vibration power you want to feel when the engine is at maximum RPM. So I'm going to go back to the sim and we'll let this continue to record. And that's the full waveform from engine idle. This is no engine idle, well, engine idle but no throttle. And as we accelerate, now we're at 20% vibration. And here comes the waveform where it gets rumbly.